Google Docs, write and edit documents. I've copied some text from the new JAWS basic training we've been working on into a blank Google Doc for this exercise. I'll move down to the second page, where there's some text, new heading here, and new text here describing the table we'll insert below.
Move to the start button. I will press tab, blank. New text, new heading here.
I'll select a line of text, new heading here.
Selected, new heading here.
One of the things you want to be able to do is reread the selected text so you can make sure the text is what you want to work with. The JAWS keystroke to reread the currently selected text is an easy one to remember if you remember it as a say all selected text. You normally select text by holding down the shift key, and a say all is insert plus down arrow. So you can remember this keystroke by that mnemonic. The keystroke is shift, insert, down arrow, and I'll press it now.
Selection is new heading here.
I'll type in some new text. How about something like JAWS help keystrokes? My typing echo is turned off, so I'll just do a say line, insert up arrow.
JAWS help keystrokes.
I'll select the line of text that reads new text here, describing the table we'll insert below.
New text here describing the table we will insert below. N.
I pressed home, and I heard JAWS read the capital N. Just so you can verify that text reads properly, you can press right arrow to go to the next character.
E. W.
And left arrow to go to the prior character.
E. N.
Control right arrow to move to the next word.
Text here.
Control left arrow to move to the prior word.
Text new.
And so on. So I'll select that by pressing shift end.
Selected new text here describing the table.
And I'm going to type in, the table below describes the five keystrokes we discussed today for getting help quickly in JAWS. I noticed I misspelled one of the words while I was typing. We'll come back to that later. Next, I'll press enter to insert a blank line.
New line.
Below this line are the five types of help that I want to put into a table. Let's insert a table next. I'll press Alt-I to open the Insert menu.
Menu Insert 4 of 9.
Next, press T for the table submenu. A grid opens. I'll press right arrow once to select two columns.
2 by 1.
And then down arrow about 4 times to select a 2 by 5 grid.
2 by 2, 2 by 3, 2 by 4, 2 by 5.
Press Enter.
Table with 2 columns and 5 rows, 2 by 5 table inserted.
The table is inserted into the document. Now I'm going to quickly select some of the text below the table for the different keystrokes. I'll select the first line, Windows key help, insert W, and press Ctrl X to cut this to the clipboard.
Row 2, row 3, row 4, row 5, blank, Windows key help, insert W, selected, Windows key help, insert plus W, cut selection to clipboard.
Next I'll move the cursor back up into the table, putting focus in column 1, row 1.
Blank, table with 2 columns and 5 rows, row 5, column 1, blank, row 4, row 3, row 2, row 1, blank.
Here I'll type, type of help. I'll press tab to move to column 2, row 1, and type keystroke.
Column 2, blank.
I'll press tab once more to move to column 1, row 2, and paste the information I cut to the clipboard earlier.
Row 2, column 1, blank. Table with 2 columns and 5 rows. Row 2, column 1, Windows key help, insert plus W. Pasted Windows key help, insert plus W.
Next, I'll select the text for the keystroke, insert W, cut it, and then paste it into the next cell in column 2.
Selected, W, selected, plus, selected, insert. Selected, insert plus W. Table with 2 columns and 5 rows. Row 2, column 1, Windows key help, cut selection to clipboard.
And I'll backspace over that comma.
Space, comma.
And then press tab.
Column 2, blank.
And paste with Control V, Victor.
Pasted insert plus W.
Finally, I'll make that keystroke bold. I'll select the keystroke once more.
Selected, W, selected, plus, selected, insert.
And then I'll press Control B, Bravo, to apply the bold attribute.
Selected, insert plus W, bold applied to selection.
Notice also, if you move to the last row in the table and press tab, a new row is inserted below.
Row 3, blank. Row 4, blank. Row 5, blank. Inserted row at row 6, cursor in row 6, column 1, table with 2 columns and 6 rows, row 6, column 1, blank.
Some of the things you should immediately notice is that it's very easy to work with text and formatting in Google Docs. Let's try a few other things now. I'm going to press Ctrl+Home to move back to the top of the document.
Top of file, JAWS help-5 quick ways to get help leaving table.
I'm going to mark up the text that should be headings with styles. The cursor is at the beginning of the line of text that reads, JAWS Help, 5 Quick Ways to Get Help. Next, press CTRL+ALT+1 to apply the Heading 1 style.
Heading 1 style applied.
Does that keystroke sound familiar? It's the same keystroke to mark up a heading at level 1 in another product you may be familiar with. Okay, I'm going to move to the other headings in the document. At the beginning of each line, I'll press CTRL+ALT+2 to mark up these as headings at level 2.
And this following blank Windows key help. Hotkey screen jaw blank Windows key help INSERT+W. Heading 2 style applied. This key blank the first type text view blank hotkey help INSERT+H. Heading 2 style applied.
I'll stop there for now. Great. Now, at the top of the page, there are 5 items that should be marked up as a bulleted list. I'll press CTRL+HOME to move back to the top of the document, and then I'll find and select those items.
Top of file, heading level 1, JAWS help, -5 quick ways to get help. In this section, we will look at 5 different quick ways to get help with JAWS. They include the following colon, blank, Windows key help.
There they are.
Selected, Windows key, selected, hotkey, selected, screen sent, selected, JAWS help, selected, JAWS help system.
Okay, let's apply the style for a bulleted list in Google Docs. I'll press CTRL+SHIFT+8 on the numbers row.
Created bulleted list with 5 items. Selected Windows key help level 2. Bullet hot.
And I pressed CTRL to stop JAWS from reading again. JAWS layered commands for Google Docs. Now, let's explore how to use JAWS layered commands for Google Docs. When using Google Docs with JAWS, press Insert Spacebar first to enter the layered mode, then Q Quebec for the Google Docs layer. Then use one of the following keystrokes. First, I'll press CTRL+HOME to move to the top of the document.
Top of file, heading level 1, JAWS help, -5, quick ways to get help.
I'll press Insert Spacebar first, and then Q, Quebec.
Quick keys.
Move to next or prior list is L or Shift+L.
Windows key help.
Move to the next or prior table is T, Tango, or Shift+T.
Table with 2 columns and 6 rows, row 1, column 1, type of help.
I'm going to press Escape to get out of the layered mode, and I'll press CTRL+HOME to move back to the top.
Top of file, heading level 1, JAWS help, -5, quick ways to get help, leaving table.
The layered command in JAWS to move to the next or prior spelling error is M or Shift+M, as in Mike. Note, you can also press the Google Docs keystroke, CTRL-apostrophe, to move to the next spelling or grammar error. I'll press that now.
Displays.
I hear the word displays. I'm going to press left arrow.
Space, spelling suggestion exited.
And I'll press right arrow to move back into the misspelled word.
D-I-S-P-L-A-Y-E-S.
When I exit by pressing right arrow, you should hear a different message.
Space, spelling suggestion exited.
I can correct that word later, but I'm going to press control apostrophe to move to the next spelling or grammar error.
Hot.
And this one is a grammar error for JAWS hotkey.
Space, gram H. Grammar suggestion.
Control apostrophe again.
Current.
There's a misspelled word for current. I'll just do the insert 5 twice quickly to spell the word.
C-U-R-R-R-E-N-T space.
And so I can get a quick overview of spelling and grammar errors. Finally, what if you want to hear the formatting at a given spot in the document to see if everything is as it should be? Press the Google Docs keystroke combo Control-Alt-A-Alpha followed by CTRL+ALT+F, Foxtrot. I'm going to press CTRL+HOME again to move back to the top of the file.
Top of file, heading level 1, JAWS help, -5, quick ways to get help.
I'll press CTRL+ALT+A, followed by CTRL+ALT+F. CTRL+ALT+A, Alpha. CTRL+ALT+F, Foxtrot.
Heading 1, font Arial, 20-point color, black, vertical, align, normal.
Let's move down to the next line and try that again.
In this section, we will look at
CTRL+ALT+A, CTRL+ALT+F.
Normal text font Arial 11-point color black vertical align normal.
In summary, you can do pretty much anything you need to in Google Docs, including moving around by character, word, line, paragraph, and more. You can select text, apply styles, find spelling errors, check formatting, and much more. And one more great thing, you don't have to save your docs. Google Docs saves your changes as you go along. Thanks for joining us in this instructional demo.
Freedom Scientific, a Vespero brand. If you are interested in other training, please visit us on the web at freedomscientific.com/training and on YouTube on our Freedom Scientific training channel.